شكرا دكتور عادل. طبعا بهني برضو دكتور صبحي على الميتنج الجميل ده، وبهني برضو على مساعدته للناس الناجحين، وبهني دكتور عمرو زكي على رئاسته للاسم. الحاله هي ال اي دي سي تي او اند بايفوركيشن. This is a case of a 50-year-old gentleman. He's current cigarette smoker, hypertensive with chronic kidney disease. He was kept on aspirin, ticagrelor, nebivolol 5 mg, candesartan 8 mg, rosuvastatin 20 mg, and amlodipine 5 mg was added because of uncontrolled hypertension. In January 2018, he was admitted to a hospital with unstable angina. Coronary angiography was done with failed trial of PCI to LAD total occlusion. We'll see the angio. We'll know why the trial was failed. After that, he was referred to our hospital because of uncontrolled recurrent anginal chest pain. His clinical examination, the patient was overweight. His blood pressure is still not controlled, 180 over 100. His heart rate was normal. Peripheral pulse is well felt. No lower limb edema. Chest was clear and heart shows S4. The ECG QS pattern in V1 and V2, but his echocardiography, ejection fraction 63, no resting segmental wall motion abnormalities, left ventricular diastolic dysfunction with concentric left ventricular hypertrophy. So this patient has a chronic total occlusion of the LAD, and he is highly symptomatic. I think this is one of the indication to open this LAD, patient normal LV function, and recurrent angina and a total occlusion of the LAD. So I decided to go. I revised the angio of this gentleman. This is ECG, just two-wave inversion, one in AVL, QS pattern in V1 and V2, and left atrial enlargement as seen in V1. This is coronary angiography, and I knew why the operator failed. Number one, actually, there is no obvious stump seen in the LAD, and at the same time, there was no collaterals from the right coronary artery filling the LAD. That's why there is no role for a contralateral injection or a dual injection. I decided to go a transradial with a 6-French guiding caster and XB guiding caster. And if we look carefully at this angiogram here, I suspected that the stump of the LAD is here. This is a small septal, and the stump is here. This is a stump, a very small one. If you look very carefully, you can check this. So I went with a microcaster. هيبان بعد كده بس مش يعني مش في دي بس مفيش كولاترالز راحة no collaterals of the LAD. لو كان في كولاترالز I would go for an injection of the right both because it's very important to know the length of occlusion, and this will appear if there is a collaterals from the right coronary artery. So I went with, this is a Felder XT caster with a Felder XT wire and fine cross microcaster. First, as you see here, the wire went to this a very small septal branch. And here, if you look very carefully, the tip of the wire starts to catch this stump as seen before. After that, the wire passed to the distal part of the LAD. And I advanced the microcaster of the wire, but I was not sure that this wasn't a true lumen. That's why I used the microcaster for injection, just to show that the microcaster is in the true lumen. This is an injection. It's a diluted contrast, very small amount, showing that we are in the distal part of the LAD and we are in the true lumen. After that, I exchanged the wire, Felder XT, with a BMW wire. and continued the procedure. It went smooth, but the LAD was diffusely diseased, just balloon dilatation. Multiple dilatation, and start by a long stent. It was a Zeiss Expedition 2.5 by 48 in the distal part. And if we look here, we have a significant ostial stenosis of this diagonal branch, which is a big artery. And I decided to stent this significant lesion in the mid part and to put a wire in the diagonal branch for a protection, just protection of the diagonal. It's just ostial stenosis. My question, if you have a just ostial stenosis of a diagonal branch, your plan from the start, would you do stenting of both LAD and diagonal in such case, or do you stent the LAD and then, like a provisional stenting, and then check the diagonal? If needed, you can put a stent, and if not, you leave it. My plan is not to compromise this diagonal branch. I plan to put a stent exactly at this part, not to compromise the diagonal, in spite I was putting a wire protecting this. But I found that the proximal part of the LAD was diseased, and that this disease part extending to the ostium of the LAD, necessitating stenting of this proximal part. So I decided to stent the LAD covering its ostium, overlapping with the med stent, and this was the third stent at 3.5 by 38, like a metal jacket of the LAD because it was a diffusely diseased artery. While we have the wire in the diagonal, protecting. Just at the ostium, I did extend to the left main. Then I deployed the stent, and it seems it's a diseased and tight stenosis in the proximal part. And this is after stenting the whole length of the LAD. I would like to know your opinion about this ostial diagonal. Yes. The options. Yes, exactly what I did, Dr. Aydin. I stopped. I left this diagonal pressure. بس لسه جاي اتفضل. يس وبعدين مد يس والسايت اند ذا سايت اوف اوفرلاب از نوت ات ذا دياجونال. اي بريسايزلي بوت ذا سكند ستنت جاست the dot or the black dot of the stent is at the diagonal. This means that the stent is 1 millimeter away from this diagonal. So the site overlap is not at the diagonal. And this is very important part. This the true size of the proximal part. Yes, yes. انا هوريه لك. ليتس بس ريفايز تاني البروكسيمال بارت ده هنا. ال اكشوالي ذيس جنتلمان ذيس از ذا ال اي دي ات ذا بروكسيمال بارت اند ذا اوستيوم. Would you leave this LED? No, this was not a spasm. Actually, I don't have the full diagnostic views. This is because I went for intervention directly, you know. I did. It was, but it became more obvious after stenting of the mid and distal part of the LED. ما انا هرجع لك تاني لل would you leave a plaque it seems significant in an artery who was totally occluded and you opened it and you are talking about the risk of stent thrombosis. You leave this a very proximal plaque in the LED involving the ostium after stenting its mid and distal part and after an opening a total occlusion, would you leave this part like this? انا بس نجيب ال 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 this is انا عايز لا لسه احنا انا لسه الحاله لسه ما خلصتش. لا لسه معلش انا بس يعني انا عايز عشان الحاله لسه فيها ده لسه فيها شغل. دي الحاله لسه ما خلصتش. طبعا I decided to leave the diagonal based على اللي احنا قلناه. It is just an ostial stenosis localized to the ostium and we have a TME3 flow in the diagonal and I agree طبعا with Dr. Adel and Dr. Sobhi to leave this diagonal without any intervention. ممكن بس كده طيب. This is the procedure. And this is the final result and I left this gentleman. 10 months later, the patient readmitted by severe persistent chest pain associated with unremarkable ECG changes, but with significant elevation of troponin. So he's diagnosed as non-ST acute coronary syndrome. On the second day, referred for a coronary angiography, his creatinine was 1.8. And this is coronary angiography after 10 months. The stents were beautifully patent, the LED was okay. And if we look at the ostium of the diagonal branch, it progressed more. It became very tight. And again here, it is a very tight ostial diagonal. And this was his right coronary artery, Dr. Ali. It was a big dominant artery and with no significant lesion. That's why I went in this case to do intervention of this diagonal branch. In this case, you can do tap technique for this bifurcation lesion. Usually I wired both the LED and diagonal, dilated the ostium and of the diagonal. And if you look here, look at the balloon. It is a very tight stenosis at the ostium. Then I bought a stent with minimal protrusion while we have a balloon in the LED. And then finished by a kissing technique. And this was the final result. Again. بص انا طبعا حضرتك عشان رجعت ده تاني انا كان في دماغي في حاجات اجينست ان انت تستنت الدياجونال برانش وفي حاجات ويز الاجينست اللي احنا قلناه ان وي هاف ا لوكالايزد اوستيال ستينوز اند وي هاف ا تي مي 3 فلو ان ذا دياجونال برانش ذيس اجينست ان انا تو بروسيد فور ستنتنج فروم ذا ستارت اللي كان ويز السايز اوف ذا دياجونال برانش اند اكشولي اي بوت ا 3 مليمتر ستنت ات واز ا سايزابل دياجونال برانش بات If we revise the bifurcation strategies in this case, you leave it because we have a localized ostial and TME3 flow. But unfortunately, the patient came back because of this chest pain. Whether to do a drug-coated balloon, زي ما دكتور عادل بيقول, or to stent, and myself, في الostial lesions, it is a fibrotic lesion, and the response to balloon dilatation will be inadequate. And I don't like to do a drug-coated balloon in such a fibrotic ostial lesion. I prefer to put a stent. And even after dilatation of this diagonal branch, if we go back, there is still residual significant stenosis after balloon dilatation. Yes, I agree. This بس with بعد شهر بعد 10 شهور هيز فاين 10 شهور هيز فاين بالظبط 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 انا 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 اي بريفير كيسنج بالون يا دكتور مصطفى kissing balloon carries the risk of dissection. ممكن بس اكومنت
جست عندك فيري تايت لا مش
ديفينتلي ويل هاف طبعا ديفرنت اوبينيونز ريجاردنج ذيس. انما في ان ميسنج بوينت في كل الدسكشن دي, يو هاف تو لوك ات ذا اكستنشن اوف ذا بلاك بياند ذا اوستيوم. اف ذا اكستنشن اوف ذا بلاك بياند ذا اوستيوم از 5 مليمتر اور مور ان ذيس كونديشن, يو هاف تو جو for dilatation and stent if needed. But if the plaque is less than 5, like this condition, it is just ostial, focal, and some cases, if you leave it like this and do angio after that, you will find the ostial lesion much, much more better than, and this is what is written as regarding the bifurcation. You do a two-stent strategy if you have a sizable side branch and the stenosis is significant and extending at least 5 millimeter behind this stenosis. If it is exactly as the ostium, you don't need to do a stenting of this side branch. That is very important. Yes.
في تو كلينيكال سيتويشنز بس برضه مهمين في البايفوركيشن, يعني حضرتك بتتكلم عليه لو احنا شغالين في تو كلين فيسلز البيرنت فيسل والسايد برانش. في حاجتين دايما بيبقوا صعبين شويه والقرار فيهم هيبقى مختلف شويه. لو انا كنت شغال على نيتف يعني على الميجر فيسل, لو كنت شغال في ال اي دي والال اي دي كان فيري كومبلكس فيري كالسيفيك اند اي هاف ا فيري بيج ديفيكولتي تو كروس, وانا وصلت ان انا فتحت ال اي دي ده اي سكسيدد تو هاف ا تيمي 3 فلو اند اف اي هاف ا سايد برانش. لو ساعات الواحد لما يخش في السايد برانش ويبتدي يحط بالون ويقول لا ده انا لسه عندي ريزيدوال ستينوزس ويحب يعدي ستانت من خلال البيرنت فيسل عشان يخش في السايد برانش, ميبي يو كان كروس, ميبي يو ويل لوز ستانت اند ميبي ويل هاف ا مور كومبليكيشنز اند ذا بيشنت ويل لوز بوث ذا مين برانش اند سايد برانش. دي فيرست كلينيكال سيتنج. سكند كلينيكال سيتنج اللي هي في الحالات الاكيوت كرون سيندروم اللي بعدهم بايفركيشن, واحد عنده ثرومبس وفي نفس الوقت بشتغل على الدياجونال وعندي ثرومبس كبيره, ولو انا وصلت ان انا عندي تيمي 3 فلو في الميجر فيسل وان انا ستيل اي هاف بروبلم ان ذا سايد برانش تو بلاي ذا سايد برانش اور نوت. الموضوع هيبقى ممكن في حاله تو بلاي وتلاقي الدنيا ماشيه كويس, ممكن تو بلاي اند يو هاف ا فيري باد ريزلت از ريجارد ذا ميجر فيسل اند ذا سايد برانش. سو يو انا في الاثنين كلينيكال سيتنجز دول, لو انا عندي كومبلكس بي سي اي في ميجر فيسل او لو عندي heavy thrombus burden for big vessel, if I have an accepted result on the side branch, I'm not going to be to solve for the better. I will accept the good or the fair. Okay?